Here is what a fresh KDE Plasma setup looks like on my Casio Aceleras. Simple, clean, with the default Breeze theme. It's nice, but let's transform it into something really magical. Before you see that, first install Quantum, the engine that lets us apply advanced Qt themes. KDE themes are made of many moving parts, and each type needs its own place in your system. So let's create it the required directories under .localshare, .themes, and .config directories. This way, whether it's a Plasma theme, Aurora window decoration, icons, console color scheme, everything has its proper home. Basically, your directory structure should look like this. For this setup, I'm going with the Dracula Dark theme as the base. Dracula is popular because it's consistent across Plasma, GTK, and Quantum, which avoids mismatched applications. Along with Dracula, I'll use Beautyline icons, Sweet Cursors, and JetBrains monophones. These all come together to create a coherent look. Of course, you can use other theme families like Lion, Arches, Sweet, or Nordic, but Dracula is a safe all-rounder. Basically, download and place each element where it belongs. Global theme in look and feel directory, Plasma theme into desktop theme directory, Aurora window decoration, color schemes, Quantum, all those elements in their respective directories like this. A good font makes a big difference. I'm using JetBrains Mono as my system font, plus some nerd fonts for terminal power-ups. You can install them easily via KDE's font management tool. Just select the lines, choose whether you want them system-wide or personal, and you're done. Now comes the fun part, applying the themes. Head into KDE settings, go to colors and themes, and select Dracula. You will notice most elements update instantly, but to get the full effect, we will also set Quantum to Dracula and adjust the window opacity for better readability. Then switch GTK apps to Dracula so your GNOME-based applications also blend in. Next, let's clear up the title bar by removing unnecessary buttons and adding useful ones, like keep above other windows. Then enable desktop effects, blur, translucency, wobbly windows, slide back animations, and the task switcher style. This is where KDE shines. Endless control over how your desktop feels. Now let's make the panel look sleek. Resize it, float it, arrange items like Windows 11. And then spice it up with widgets. I'm adding a global menu, system monitor, sticky notes, a modern clock widget, and more. Widgets are KDE's secret sauce, letting you shape your workflow exactly the way you want. Customization doesn't stop at the desktop. Dolphin, the file manager, can be tuned too. Repositioning toolbars, adding quick actions, and showing preview panels. And for console terminal, I'm applying the Sweet Color Scheme, cleaning up the toolbar and adding useful buttons like clear scroll back and copy input to all terminals. A few tweaks and it feels completely different. Personalize your system even more by setting a user profile photo. Next, you can change the STDM theme too if you want. I'm using the Nordic STDM theme in here, giving the system a dark, modern look even before logging in. However, this one is optional and you may skip it if you're not comfortable with using root permission for a cosmetic change. Also note that a faulty STDM theme may cause login issues, so the decision is all yours. Want advanced styling like i3 but inside KDE? Install the Cronkite Kvin script. It automatically tiles your windows and you can fine-tune gaps and layouts. It's perfect for productivity junkies. And here is the final look. Dracula global theme, Beautyline icons, Sweet Cursors, and all the tweaks we applied. Tiled windows, global menu in the panel, custom console, and a sleek STDM login screen. A desktop that doesn't just look good, but it feels like it's truly yours. That's how you manually customize KDE Plasma from the ground up. It's a bit of work, I accept, but the flexibility you gain is unmatched. Now, You tell me, which theme combo would you try for your system? Let me know in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe and share it with your Linux friends. See you in the next video.